building, DDCTV once again. In a place to be with a very special guest from Raleigh, North Carolina. Miss Ziggy in the building. What's up, Ziggy?
What's up?
How you doing?
I'm doing good.
Doing good?
Yeah.
So we out here at Rich Belief Studios, another Saturday night, and happy to catch you here. Seen you in the building a couple times, and you know, you're such a draw of attention. I think like people can't even help but, you know what I'm saying, extend their attention to you. Mm-hmm. So tell us like what brought you to Atlanta. Tell us a little bit about your history, your story, you know, growing up in North Carolina and what's going on.
So what brought me to Atlanta is like basically more opportunities. And also out here, you know, what I see out here is, you know, everybody helping everybody. You know, everybody want to help everybody grow. Back in my city, they don't really, you know, they don't really do that. Most people are focused on like education, medicine, and sports. That's basically what my city is, you know, mostly about. Like North Carolina got one of the best schools, basically.
Oh yeah, so well, we know about the basketball for sure.
Yeah.
You know, I used to play
ball.
Yeah,
we got UNC, Duke, A&T, Central. Like, we have a lot of good schools out there.
Right.
And so I feel like that's basically what it's based on, really, education and medical, you know, medical and all that. So I came here because this is more of like an entertainment city, you know, more of if you want to be in the industry, you want to be acting, dancing, there's more opportunities out here.
Well, you can't beat that. You jump on the road 3 hours. Yeah. Well, I don't know. Where is Raleigh? How far is Raleigh?
6 hours.
Okay, my bad. That's the other side of North Carolina.
Yeah,
okay, that's not Charlotte.
Nah.
Okay.
It's like, yeah, Charlotte's like 3-4 hours from Raleigh.
Okay.
Like a 6 hour.
So how old are you?
I'm 22 years old.
22?
Yeah.
Okay. And you've been in the city of Atlanta for about, you said 3 years?
2 years.
2 years?
Yeah.
Okay. So in North Carolina, I think of North Carolina as like, not all the way south. It's like kind of in between. They rock a lot of New York vibes, but it still could be the south.
Yeah.
So how do you feel like?
Well, it depends on what part of North Carolina you're from. Like, I'm from Raleigh, like the city.
Okay.
Like, I was born in the city part. So it's like a little city vibe there. But you do have like, you do get the country vibes, you know.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
So y'all country.
Yeah. Like, you can say we're country.
Okay.
It's a little bit of everything, really. Like, it was right about that, so.
Okay, but in terms of music, like, what flavors do you hear the most when it comes to hip-hop? Like, what, if I go to Raleigh right now and turn on the most popular radio station, what are they playing?
Shoot, because, you know, right now, a lot of people, in my opinion, a lot of people sound like, you know, the baby is Stunna, you know?
Okay.
Because they come from out of North Carolina. You know, the baby from Charlotte, and I believe Stunna's from Salisbury, North Carolina.
Right.
So, right now, that's a lot of flavor that's going around right now. You know, the baby, that, you know, that type of wave. So.
Right. Yeah. He's doing a lot of collaborations.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
he's
going crazy.
Oh, yeah.
Bananas, right?
Yeah.
So I know y'all happy about that, huh?
Yeah.
Y'all got a winner from the home state.
Yeah, and J. Cole.
Right.
J. Cole, I want to say Fayetteville, North Carolina.
Okay.
Here,
I didn't even know that. I thought he was like from somewhere. I thought he was from Philly or something.
Well, now he's from North Carolina.
Okay. Well, you just never know how it goes. People can be born in a place and they can move someplace. Like Atlanta is a city of those stories.
Yeah.
You know, like the very first hip hop real DJ and MC here was DJ Shy D from New York.
Yeah.
And then after that, but the people in Atlanta didn't really embrace him because he was too New York. But he picked up on like the fast tracks, you know what I'm saying? The hi-hats. Miami bass, and he engineered a sound that people liked, but they just didn't show him the love. And then really Kilo Ali came after him, because Atlanta was still on booty shake music back in them days, you know. But fast forward 10-20 years later, and here you are. So what style do you like to do?
Honestly, I like popping, because that's kind of what I grew up on. Like, I grew up popping, but like my favorite style, like right now, is probably hitting the folks. I ain't gonna lie.
Hitting them folks?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's like my favorite style to do, but mostly like what I'm known to do is probably like popping. Pop, you know, stuff like that.
So growing up in Raleigh, when you was younger as a kid, can you remember like who influenced you musically not necessarily even just dance, but because the music comes before the dance, right? So what was it that you was listening to? What are some of the things that you just remember, or some of the things that just stamped on your heart, like, this is it, you know what I mean?
First it was definitely Missy Elliott.
Okay.
Like, Missy Elliott, you know, that era was crazy, so I remember being, like, when I was younger, you know what I'm saying? I remember, like, the little talent shows we did in elementary school. I would always pick a Missy Elliott songs. I would get off on that, like, Lose Control, Busta Rhymes, all that. That's, like, kind of what I, you know, kind of grew up off of. Also, after that, it was Chris Brown. About the 2000, you know, when he came out, that's when I was like, this dude nice. I think it was Run It. The first video I seen it was Run It on BET. I'm like, ever since then.
I remember the first time I heard Chris Brown's name. I was like, it was like, yeah, Chris Brown. I said, Chris Brown. That sounded like one of the Peanuts. Who was that? They're like, nah, he's this dude. He like Michael Jackson. He can dance. He can sing.
Oh yeah.
And then I saw him, and I was like, okay.
He was killing it.
Yeah.
That's when I just started. Like, I looked up to him. Like, that's one of my idols, to be honest. And Missy Elliott. Cause those are like where I really started. Like, get my tools.
Those are like two of the best performers and overall cultural movers. You know what I mean?
And they show a lot of love to the dancers out here.
That's what I'm saying. Like, for dance, but, like, they're dance cultural movers. Like, Missy, she puts you right up there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and she actually likes it so much. Like, she's fans of a lot of people that she calls up. She might see something and like, hey, gotta have them. Concept. Boom, boom.
Yeah, so those are my two items right there.
Okay, so you along with your brother, y'all started your own company and brand called Iconic Entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about Iconic Entertainment. Like, what exactly does it do, and what's like the vision for it?
Okay, so basically the reason why we started Iconic is because, you know, they have like a lot of agencies out here. You know, like, I want to say Excel. You got a lot of agency, and basically we wanted to be our own agency. Like, we sick of knocking at people's doors. We like, man, we're gonna make our own stuff. But what we do, we're not really more so an agency. We're just more so like, because you have a lot of dancers out here with a lot of potential. They just don't have that support. They don't know what to do, where to go, how to go about it. And we basically just show them how to go about it, what to do, get them good content on their page, clean photos, gigs, stuff like that, so that they, you know, excel and, you know, do good, basically. That's basically what we do.
Okay, so it sounds like y'all do what we do.
Yeah.
Like, no, seriously, like, that's one of the main pillars of mission statement for DDC. Is like, digital dance culture is all about culture and becoming like a trust. By that meaning, we keep and you know what I'm saying, record history as it comes. We record the cultures, the dancers. And we just monitor the evolution, and we extend like opportunities through the platform.
Mm-hmm.
But within that, it's the same thing. It's like consulting, basically. It's like, okay, you know, go and put your tie on. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you look like this.
Right.
Like your page. Like, make sure your page is clean. Make sure you have these type of content on there. Yada, yada, yada.
Yeah.
But that's good. I mean, we need more people that are in it for the dancers, because it seems like over the last, I don't know how long, dancers are just like side show, side piece, extras.
Yeah.
Like, the career of a dancer
is deeper. It's deep.
Right? So, yeah, okay. So,
yeah, we just got sick and tired of asking people, like, hey, we trying to look over here, hey, knocking at these doors, create our own door.
Right.
For other people, so that they don't have to do all that, you know?
Well, it's 2019, we head into 2020.
Yeah.
So if you ain't got clear sight by now, I don't know what to tell you. You gotta have that 2020
on this new year. Got to.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's what's up. Okay, so who do you rock with? Like, who do you hang with? What dancers are you associated with? Or what do y'all do on a regular basis, like, in the city of Atlanta? Like, do y'all go out to events? What's going on?
Okay, so usually what we do, we'll pick a song. Well, me and my brother, you know, we work with True Culture as well. I don't know if you heard of
True Culture?
Yeah. It's Because you know, like now, how they got on Instagram, they got like clicks. Like, you know, little clicks. They got troll culture, you know, the click. They got T-Gay, the hype. You know, they got a little groups.
Okay.
Like
right.
out here. So basically, we work with troll culture a lot. So, like, we'll link up, you know, they'll be like, let's do this song. And we'll go, okay, you want to do this song? How can we make this video look creative and different from other videos out here? Other right. sessions, how can we be creative and go to the next step?
Right.
Like, that's how we think about, you know, how we do our videos.
Okay, okay. So, it's like technology has taken us to this space where it didn't used to be like this.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
No, but it's good because it's like it brings everybody together in a mm-hmm. sense. Because now you get a chance to see what everybody else is doing. Mm-hmm. It's the ultimate mix going on. It's like everything is just mixed up. It's like there's no one genre anymore. It's like I'm going to take a little bit of this. Oh, I see that footwork. I like that movie. I don't know what that means. Yeah. But I'm going to bring it over here. Then I'm going to put some hit them folks in there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's crazy right now.
I'm going to put a wall in here.
Well, yeah.
You know what I mean? I might put some pop in. I might throw some beat your feet in here.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So it's like we call it a trend dance, but it's becoming almost like this universal American style.
Oh, yeah.
That's what's happening.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But, you know, we come from the Memphis Jukin, yeah, not era, but just we cut from that cloth. And that's important because the Memphis culture is one of the probably strongest cultures when it comes to developing the dance style, maintaining the dance style, everybody's still together, kind of shouting out the dance style. Like, crumping ran its course. Now it's like, where are the crumpers?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then you have different regions like DC, Beat Your Feet.
Mm-hmm.
But Beat Your Feet never made it like nationwide. The people who dance might have known about it, but never made it like
Jukin, basically.
What you say?
Like Jukin right now.
Yeah.
Jukin is crazy right now. And I respect the culture so much that I wasn't really that aware of how crazy it was like back in the day.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I was looking at some battles, you know, some of everything. I'm like, this is crazy. This is like life, you know, in Memphis.
Yeah.
Like, this is,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, in New York, they got they light feet. You know, they stuff go back.
Right.
And I was looking at y'all, I'm like, that's wild. Because, like, now that I'm starting to jump into it a little bit, you know, trying to learn, I was like, let me just see where, you know, go back in time and just really look and see how, you know, how things were and how it is now and stuff like that.
Right.
So I've been, you know, I do my research on different cultures when I try to jump in different cultures. So
right, right.
And learn.
Right.
That's why I feel like a lot of people lack some time too. They don't really learn what's really going on. They just want to jump in. Hey, I see you doing this before. Let me do it. You
well, you know what?
What?
Like, and people are very protective of their stuff.
Yeah.
And it's like when they see younger people just come in and take something and become famous. It actually creates like some resentment because they like, wait a minute, we've been working on this for 20 years. Here this young kid coming here on Instagram, he's taking our moves and now he's famous and doing this and doing that. Like, what do you think about that?
I feel like they have a right to be mad though, because it's like, this is how I look at it. Okay, so if I come in here and do a move, right? And I got it from this person, and it goes viral. I'm gonna pay homage to that person I got it from. Like, I'm not gonna sit up here and act like I just took the whole credit. I'm gonna pay homage to that person to make sure, hey, this is who I was watching, this is who I studied. Like, it's cool to be, you know what I'm saying, it's different. I feel like it's different between fighting and being inspired.
Right.
When you're being inspired, you're gonna always pay homage to that person. But when you bite, you're just gonna bite and go. Like, I just learned this, get that, go
right
with it. I feel like that's, so I feel like sometimes they do have a right to be mad about it. You're not original, and you ain't even giving a man his props from what you just seen.
Right,
you know?
right. Indeed. Well, you know, American dance styles, most of the urban dance styles, if not all, that we look at in terms of hip-hop, were started here. And if you think about it, in Europe, it's like street dance has been industrialized. Like, they're doing humongous events. Even in Asia,
mm-hmm.
you know what I mean? So, like, they've taken it to a whole nother level in terms of making money and having, like, big sponsored events. Now, we just had the Red Bull thing going on here, but they've been doing that for years. You know what I'm saying? So when you think of like, what's the brother's name? You know who I'm talking about. Les Twins.
Oh yeah, Les Twins.
Yeah, so it's like, actually the Europeans came here and watched everything that we had and they went back
to
Europe and they said, hey, we've been to do some business. Mm-hmm. And we was out here basically still getting messed over by the industry. Okay, yeah, come do this. You know, here's $50.
Yeah.
You know, thank you. Mm-hmm. Unless you were a choreographer, it really was not an industry for street dance.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So like, how can you, how can an iconic group like kind of make a way, you know what I'm saying, for up and coming people? Like, what is it that people are missing?
I feel like people are missing knowledge. Like, that's probably one of the most important things. That's what I was missing when I first started, but I gained it over time. And meaning knowledge, I mean, like, people that have like 80,000 views, 100,000 views, and over here getting paid $50 for a gig. You know what I'm saying? I feel like you should know your work. Like, you know, like, you shouldn't be getting paid $50. Like, depending on the event, the company, who the people are, you should get more than that. You know, for example, you go to a club. Let's say they say, I want to pay you $100 to perform. $100 to perform, that's nothing versus what I'm going to bring. You know, I'm going to bring about, shoot, if I'm going to get, I'm going to pay $100 for this, I can throw my own event and do my own branding, my own stuff, and make this amount of money.
Right.
And I feel like a lot of people sometimes follow this way, like that everybody's going. They'll follow this way, trying to go this way, like, hey, help me, help me, help me. But sometimes when that door closes on you, you gotta go open up another door. Or find your own way, make your own way. That's why I feel like a lot of people lack. Everybody wanna do what this person did. I wanna see how they did it. I wanna do it the way they did it. That's not always a good thing. You gotta figure out what makes you different and how you gonna go do your own pathway.
Yeah, because you're a different person, so you can't do it like they did.
Yeah, how they did it, yeah.
Because you're not thinking like they think. So even if they gave you the blueprint, you still wouldn't process it the same way.
The same way, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like you got to say, okay, what's going on right now? How do I need to do this in the best way? You know what I mean?
And also, like people, you know, they'll dance on Instagram, make videos. A famous person will post them. You might get a few likes, this. But I feel like now it takes more than just likes and followers to be able to be on a business perspective. Like, you gotta take it over Instagram. Like, you can't just be on Instagram getting all these views. How you gonna make your money? Like, Instagram gonna do it for you, but you gotta market something. You gotta stamp something in order for you to make that money, you know?
You gotta clearly define your products and services.
And
then understand who's your clients.
Yeah,
I got this traffic. I got this traffic, but what am I going to do with it? How can I maximize it? You know what I'm saying? So I understand. You know, there's some companies out there doing stuff like that. Of course, your agencies, but then there's some independents who are focusing on, you know, they're basically agencies, I guess, because they just get influencers and say, hey, I can broker these deals for you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. And another thing, like, I feel like it's an investment. Like, if you want the good quality stuff, sometimes you gotta invest in stuff. Like, so what? I have a 100K followers. I'm still gonna pay for this, but I gotta pay for this to make myself better. You know what I'm saying? I might start, like, for example, you got 100K followers, right? What you gonna do? See me? I'll be like, let's start a clothing brand. So I can ship it out to everybody. Let's start this. You know, you gotta be in a business mindset when you're on social media now. You can't just be out there dancing. You know, for example, Jackson. That man, he's a businessman, in my opinion. Because he took his move and ran with it. Like, ran with it. He out here making business and doing all this. Like, I feel like that's a business. That's a business mindset. You know, even if he wasn't getting booked, he got his dance. He got his training.
I saw them doing that on some show. I was like, oh my gosh.
Man, he going crazy with it.
Yeah.
10K cash, you know. The Dallas movement, the woke, you know. They stamped that. And, you know, ran with it.
Right.
So, you gotta know, like, you just can't be, you gotta have a meaning for everything you do. You can't just go up here and make videos like, hey, I'm a I'm gonna go viral. Cool, you go viral now. What?
Right.
Now what's next?
So 9 times out of 10, it's like 4 or 5 people next to you that went viral.
Viral
with you.
Right after you. That's
so.
What I'm
so the question becomes, who ready to go to the next level?
Ready? Yeah. You that's that's mean? How people gotta think. You know. So that's okay. How I see social media and business and everything. That's what people like in my opinion. They don't like that knowledge.
Okay. So you gonna show us what you got? You gonna give us a little something?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we appreciate you coming out. Any last shout outs or people you wanna pay homage to?
Yeah, shout out to Iconic for show, shout out to my brother, shout out to my Iconic fam, shout out to Chill Culture, shout out to everybody that's out here grinding and working. Never, you know, keep going. It's gonna pay off.